He says he was performing great wonders and signs among the people. It brings me to verses 9 and 10. We're to deal with external opposition. We've got to stand with God's power. Secondly, we must stand against godless philosophy. We must stand against godless philosophy. Listen, everybody talking about some kind of new knowledge. Listen, there's nothing new under the sun. A whole lot of philosophy, and I'm going to touch on it a little bit. I've been corresponding with the brother, and listen, there's so much garbage out there. And listen, we've got to stop playing, and we've got to train and make disciples so that our people understand the Word of God, so that you're able to identify truth from error. Stand against godless philosophies. It says in verse 9 and 10, but some men from what was called the synagogue of the freedmen. We'll just stop right there for a second. Now again, this message primarily is to the Jews. The church is growing. By this time, there is estimated, scholars say, about 480 synagogues. The people read almost as many churches. You see many churches among many cities, and the synagogues were much like that. Verse 9 again, but some men from what is called by Pompey. He took them to Rome, and then they came back. When they came back to Jerusalem, they established the synagogue. So this is one of the synagogues that they're referring to here. But some men from what was called the synagogue of the freedmen, including the Cyrenians. The Cyrenians is in North Africa. This is where Simon was. If you remember Simon, the Cyrenian, he was the black man who was to carry the cross of Jesus. We're talking Africa right now. And why is this important? I'm going to tell you why it's important. It's important because they're black cults. Let me say this very clearly and carefully. They are black cults that are targeting the black church to appeal to your blackness. Let me say that again, just so y'all understand. They are black cults that appeal to black churches to appeal to your blackness. And you better be very, very careful that you don't start carrying a banner that leads you away from your Christness. Listen, your Christness is more important than your blackness. Yes. And so they were asking, well, where is Africa in the Bible? You see black people in the Bible. Yes, there are black people in the Bible, but there are lost people in white, in Asian, in Hispanic. There are people who are lost, and you get lost in your ethnicity. It's not about your ethnicity. It's about your lostness and how you can be made clean through the blood of the Lamb. You can say it loud, I'm black, and I'm proud, I'm Hispanic, and I'm proud, I'm Asian, and I'm proud. But listen, the thing that we ought to be more excited about is that we've been made clean by the blood of the Lamb. Says there, Cyrenians, North Africans, the Alexandrians, these are North Africa also. Also, they probably are of the same synagogue. So all of these people are coming together. Out of North Africa, you have Apollos. Apollos was probably African, and he was mighty in the scriptures. By the time we get to Acts chapter 18, it speaks of Apollos. Let's just take a peek there real quick. Acts chapter 18. The ministry of Apollos starts in verse 24 of 18. It says, now a Jew named Apollos, an Alexandrian by birth, an eloquent man, came to Ephesus, and he was right, he was mighty in the scriptures. Doesn't really say that about many other people in the Bible, but he was mighty in the scriptures. By the way, You're not conscious. Listen, you're not part of the conscious community. Listen, your consciousness should bring you to the realization that you're messed up and you need to be made clean through the blood of the Lamb. Or you serve the white man's God. Listen, God is not a respecter of persons. Listen, Africa, the gospel was on the shores of Africa long before white people got there. Just so you know that. You're not looking at a white man's God. This is not a black man's God either. This is he died for the sin of the world. God so loved the cosmos, the world, that he gave his only begotten Son. Listen, we cannot allow these cults to divide us and make us look at our white brothers, our Hispanic brothers, and the people who are different from us any different. Because listen, the foot of the cross is level. Listen, you can be proud of who you are. Nothing wrong with being proud of who you are. As a white person, you can have white pride. As a black person, you can have black pride and all that. It's cool because God made you who you are. You ought to have pride in who you are. But you need to understand that you are nothing without being cleansed by the blood of the Lamb. He says he was eloquent man. He came to Ephesus and he was mighty in the scriptures, Acts chapter 18, verse 25. The man had been instructed in the way of the Lord, and being fervent in spirit, he was speaking and teaching accurately the things concerning Jesus. It's not about us. No matter what color you are, listen, you ought to be preaching and teaching the gospel, because it is the gospel that is the power of God unto salvation. I don't care how black you are or who, what nation you come from, you need the gospel of Jesus Christ. He said he was teaching accurately the things concerning Jesus. Listen, there's a whole bunch of Jesuses out there. Y'all need to understand that. Everybody preaching Jesus is not preaching the Jesus of the scriptures. He said, being acquainted only with the baptism of John, and he began to speak out boldly in the synagogue. But when Priscilla and Aquila heard him, they took him aside and explained to him the way of God more accurately. And when he wanted to go across to Achaia, the brethren encouraged him and wrote to the disciples to welcome him. And when he had arrived, he greatly helped those who had believed through grace. For he powerfully refuted the Jews in public, demonstrating by the scriptures that Jesus was the Christ. Amen. They don't want to hear this. Listen, in the synagogue, in this new message of Jesus and his death, his burial, and his resurrection, and salvation that comes to all who believe, they don't want to hear that in the synagogues. Back to chapter 6. Trying to give you an understanding of who these people are and who Peter is having to deal with. It says, but the men from what was called the synagogue of the freedmen, including both Cyrenians and Alexandrians and some from Cilicia and Asia, that's a modern-day Turkey. That's that particular geographic area. And listen, we're talking about all these people coming together. Now they are concerned that there is, what's the new word as we talk about our president and their collusion? They're crying, there's some type of collusion going on. This message is growing and folk are being saved. The priests are being saved in the synagogue, and something has to happen because we've got to silence this message. You've got to know that Satan always tries to silence the message of God. Listen, and that's how in our ethnicity we start getting, you know, Black Lives Matter. Listen, I understand Black Lives Matter. I get that. White lives matter also. All lives matter because all lives were made in the image and the likeness of God. He created them. Now, I understand what's going on in America. I understand that African Americans Satan always tries to silence the message. Something else that causes that Satan uses is sin. He uses sin of the believer. That's why in chapter 5, Ananias is the fire. They stand as an example of those who are being hypocritical in the church. And one of the other things that Satan uses, separation. He would try to divide us. You see great work going on up to this point in the church because they were on one accord. But some men from what was called the synagogue of the freedmen, including both Cyrenians and Alexandrians, and some from Cilicia and Asia, rose up and argued with Stephen. Now these guys are looking at what's going on. Folk are being saved. Priests who are over the temple and the synagogue, they're getting saved. It says this in verse 7. At the end, priests were becoming obedient to the faith. We've got to stop this movement. So all of these, in this geographic area, they come together, and it says that they argued with Stephen. This word argue is to seek inquiry or to get to the bottom of the matter. They're trying to figure this thing out. This message has to be stopped. But they were unable to cope with the wisdom and the spirit with which he was speaking. When I read this, this takes me back to Gamaliel's advice in chapter 5, and Gamaliel says to the guys, listen, hey, y'all need to be real careful about what y'all doing with these guys. For if this plan or this action is of men, it will become overthrown. Verse 39, it says, but if it is of God, you will not be able to overthrow them, or else you may even be found fighting against God. Stephen stands as a representative for God. And they're arguing, they're debating with him. And what they have is human intellect. Human intellect without the Spirit of God is just intellect. You can argue and you can make you think you make valid arguments, but without the Spirit of God, it has no substance. It says, so they rose up and they argued with Stephen, but they were unable to cope with the wisdom and the Spirit. By the way, the Spirit gives wisdom. And also the Spirit gives power. If you have the Spirit of God, you should have wisdom and you should have power. When you're operating in the Spirit, you will be wise and you will be powerful. Stand against opposition by standing with God's power. We deal with external opposition also in Roman numeral 2 by standing against godless philosophy. You know, I found myself in debates, you know, over the scriptures, and it's just not profitable. In fact, in Titus, in the book of Titus, chapter 3, there's a reminder. Titus chapter 3, verse 1, let me just read it very quickly. Remind them to be subject to the